Good day. It's Gary from G&H Honeybees. And what started out to be an overcast, cool day has turned into a clear skies, hot day. It's about 24 Celsius. It's in the mid 70s in Fahrenheit. It's the 30th of June, of course. And you look at this box here, I've got three brood chambers, and I've got three honey supers on here. I added a lot of extra space to them just to see if I could keep them from swarming, because last time I looked, there were some swarm cells in here. So I want to have a look and see if they've moved up into the third honey box or not, and then we'll have a look at the bottoms of the frames and the brood chambers. See if there's any signs of swarming still. Oh yeah, they've moved right up to the top. Let's see if. Now I have removed the. Oh yeah, it's already got honey in it. I have removed the queen excluder between the third box and the fourth box. Heavy. How are we doing in here? Well, they haven't started the capping yet. They're still drawing the wax out because this is 9 frame. They're going to draw this wax out nice and wide. But that's full of nectar. Both sides of that. They're still. Oh, they are starting to cap a little bit of that, but some of these are drawn out a little wider. That's what they do. When you put 9 frames in there, they'll make the comb wider. It'll accommodate more honey. Rid of some of this extra comb. I know they're using it for ladders and they'll just make it again, but when I set that box back on top, I'll probably end up squishing a bunch of bees. Because you know they've got to be all over that comb. So this is the frame that I took out the other day, replaced it, and they've already got that full of honey again. Same on that side. They even fixed up that comb a little bit. Set that over there. Here, let's get you in here a little closer where you can see. in a brood there. And there's a queen cell. Take that off. Some more queen cups. These guys are kind of feisty. So they've backfilled that already. Even when the brood's hatched out of there, they're just filling it. There's not much nectar coming in from the blackberries. They're just going to town. Which is a really good thing in one instance, but really bad in another if you're thinking about swarming. So that's all. I don't know if the sun will catch them or not, but you can see the royal jelly, maybe, on the bottoms of those cells. So she's laid that all up. There's fresh eggs on this side, so she's laid that. Another queen cell, right there. Pump full of royal jelly. I'm sort of surprised that this box started out with like less than a pound of bees in it. In March. Oh, there she is right there. See her. Oh, and they've been cleaning her too. Some of her red mark is disappearing. But she's still nice and fat. See her. I'm trying to get her in the center of the. And she's laying this frame up. And she's laid this side all up. And where'd she go? She's still there. Oh yeah, she's still there. She's sticking her head in the cells looking for places to put eggs. So let's get her back in there. If I have to, I'll do an artificial swarm on her. Queen cells there, but that's a middle frame. That should be brood, and that's all honey. I think I'm gonna move that over to the outside. There's a lead in that frame yet, so I'm gonna slide these two over. That in there because I know she's on that frame there. Okay, this is good. This is all brood. And a couple of queen cups. It's got brood on it. Good. I think this is going to be. This might be brood. Let's hope this is brood. her brood right in the middle there where she's got room to lay, but the rest of that's all been packed in with honey. And same on that side. It's got brood and honey on it. And that's all honey on that side, so I'm going to turn that frame around. I guess I should look at the bottom of it. I didn't look at the bottom of that one. No queen cells. There's a lot of bees in this box. This is all honey. See that in there? That should be brood, but it's honey. And I hope that's a right on that end there. There's a, I think that's a drone cell. At least I hope it's a drone cell. Just gonna leave it. Queen cups there. Just pinch them off. Alright, so get these moved back over. And I'm just going to slide this one forward or backwards, I guess. Slide it that way a bit, tilt it up. See some queen cups in there. Hope I'm not in your way. Let's get rid of those. They don't look like they've got anything in them. They're just practice ones. Now, the more you look, the more you see. Get out of there. Alright, so I've knocked them out. Let me just set back down. Out of the way. gonna finish putting this back together and call it a wrap on this box. Looks good. We saw the queen. She's nice and fat. Got rid of a couple of queen cells and they are filling all three honey supers. So, those boxes are heavy. I'm glad I'm not using deeps. Anyway, that's all I got for today. Maybe tomorrow we'll look into the other box over here. This is one that I took all them queens out of. I guess it was Monday. Sunday or Monday, can't remember now. And there is a new queen in there. And whether she's made it or not, I don't know yet. So hopefully we'll find out in a few days, and then they can be prepped to go up to the bush. I'd like to see them finish off at least one box of honey each here, blackberry honey, that I can take off and extract. And that way I'm not carrying a lot of weight up to the bush. I really don't want to be carrying a, you know, a 300-pound colony on my trailer. So anyway, hope you're all having a good day, and we'll catch you again in the next video. I'd like to thank you all for watching. Bye for now.